Imagine, if you will, a world much like our own. Yeah, I know, a pretty fucking scary thought, just bear with me, okay? There are, of course, a few exceptions, like the existence of East and West America. But of course, what makes this world so different, in the end, all corresponds to one key event. The year is 1987. Kettlewell Sciences had been keeping track of some strong EMF readings found across the globe. Along with some other scientific mumbo-jumbo I won't really get into, they decided it'd be best if they sent out groups of researchers to investigate what was going on exactly. Out of the 7 groups that were dispersed, none of them came back. Well, all except for one, that is. But we'll get back to him in a moment. To fully understand, we need to cover the missing persons of Stardust Woods. Stardust Woods is a national park located about an hour west of Overidge, Ansbury, East America. This was one of the hot spots that Kettlewell Sciences was looking into. Their group that they sent out consisted of 10 people. The home base was able to keep communications until about a week went by and it was cut short. Authorities, search parties, and the like kept looking for the next year for these lost souls, and some of them went missing too. In total, 22 people just vanished. With so many people missing, and it just being months since anyone was last seen, the city called off the search and concluded it as a cold case. Until the unthinkable happened. Almost exactly 1 year later, one of the original researchers emerged from the depths of the forest. This man was Richard Weimark. He had a lot to hide and quite a big thing to sell.
It's time for the game to begin.
A year later after his return, Richard Weimark opened up his own business, Weimark Laboratories, his goal being to carry on his long-gone companion's work. Weimark Lab's big shtick is that they now offer these blood transfusions. There was 2 things he offered, Grim B and Grim X. Grim B was a lot more expensive and a lot more organic and pure, as he put it, and Grim X was cheaper, but just as pure, just made with some artificial components. At least that's what he told the public. What does this stuff do exactly? Well, Weimark Labs promised that this would give people superhuman abilities, or as Richard tagged them, variants. They had been tested and proven to work, as he had tested and did it on himself, was able to gain variant manipulation of kinetic energy. This sort of thing was marketed mainly towards nerds and the sort, and the appeal of either living out your comic book dreams or just simply for power or whatever it may be brought in quite a few people. Rightfully, the government started freaking the hell out. maybe we need to keep it, you know, this isn't good. Hey, Richard, buddy, would you be willing to, I don't know, work with us and help stabilize this stuff? Because this is, you really shouldn't be having this being handed out like candy on the streets. And Richard's like, no, F off, I do what the hell I want. And they're like, ah, shit, okay, well, what do we do? Couldn't really force him, so they had to up with a workaround. So they had this big meeting. A very important player was in this meeting. Clancy Carson had been known across the world as a very, very well-known detective, who started from nothing and made herself to where she is now. There hasn't been a case she hasn't solved, and she has had a very intelligent mind. And she came up with the proposal of what would later become the Hero Force. Essentially, bringing in people who had variants to fight people with variants, fighting fire with fire. And that's kind of where things trickled down. Weimark Labs bought out Kettlewell Sciences, took over Kettlewell locations that were all over the globe. Clancia kept a close eye on Richard and tried to dig up dirt, but wow, everything was really under lock and key. Because something wasn't really lining up. Maybe things were deeper than they seemed. Maybe something a bit supernatural. Yeah, I know. It's a jump. It sounds like a jump. Just bear with me, okay? So I bet you've heard of urban legends. Bigfoot, Yeti, Mothman, Chupacabra. Ooh, I did not say that right. No, but there's another one in this universe. The Legrims. They may be more fact than fiction. But that's just a theory. A comic theory. It's too soon to say make that joke, isn't it? But yeah, that kind of takes us, like, in the late 80s, early 90s, all the way to when the story starts. March 12th, 2022. Where, we meet our boy, our main character, Tobias Garfield. He's decided to join Hero Force. Things kind of go downhill from there, I'll put it like that. How do I sell, like, the actual plot of the story, maybe? After several months of being trapped in a paranormal forest, Tobias sets out to join the Hero Force to learn more about what happened. In the midst of it all, he faces criminals, mysteries, enemies to friends, and way more than he could have ever anticipated. Discovering there's more than what meets the eye, Tobias must learn their secrets and stop them from reaching their goals. Lives depend on it. But anyway, yeah, that's about the basic spill. At least I fucking think I covered everything. But yeah, I mean, like, I don't, you want to hear more about this? I'm not really sure what to do from here. I have ideas for a couple other videos. I mean, there's still the monster making thing, which has been honestly kind of nightmarish. Making horror monsters is actually a lot more work than I thought. I have a Silverbloom video I've been meaning to make. But if you want to hear more specifically about Grimwake, please let me know in the comments what you'd like to hear, whatever. I'd be more than happy to go in depth about whatever. Shoot, your question might spawn into a video idea for all we know. I have considered, I know people are, like, I don't want to say, like, they're weird about reading, but people don't necessarily like to read and prefer to listen to things. And I've considered, as cringy as this might sound, I've considered, like, getting me and some of my friends together who are also interested to voice dub the first season of Grimwake, because that, don't know when this video will be going up, but at this point it'll probably be right around, if not after, season one is already done. So it would just be a matter of if y'all want it, if friends are all up for it again still. And so then, if you want to enjoy the story of Grimwake so far, you're able to, like, hear it and not have to read it necessarily, you know. But if you do want to read it, please go check it out on Webtoons and Tapas. I do recommend Tapas. Because everything's a lot more HD. Webtoon compresses it quite a bit, but I understand that Webtoon is, like, the go-to for a lot of people that read webcomics, so it's completely fine. I just wanted to shoot that out there. If you want a more in-depth video, I'm going to be making a bit of a director's cut where I kind of go more in-depth. If you want to check that out, that will be available on my Patreon as soon as possible. I always update once a week, every Wednesday. I typically aim for noon Eastern time. If you want to help out and support the channel and just everything that I do,
I mean, so you get all this stuff right here for only $2 a month. Am I underselling myself? Yeah, I know I am. In this economy, I feel like I kind of have to. I don't know. But anyway, I'm gonna stop because I don't like marketing and pushing things. Good, bad, and
yeah, that's about it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.